All these hostages need a lift. Do you have the chops to take them to the latest episode of Eurobits? Choplifter is one of those old-school computer games that was ported on every system under the sun. Usually on the Master System, these come in two flavors. Ports of janky Amiga games like the Flintstones, or masterfully crafted works like Prince of Persia. Choplifter, mercifully, lies on the latter half of the spectrum. The original Choplifter was released on the Apple II in 1982 by Brother Boone Software Inc. However, the Master System version is actually based on the arcade release of Choplifter, which was handled by Sega and licensed from the original creator. And when compared to the coin-operated take on the game, it's quite faithful, with vibrant visuals, varied backgrounds, and a large number of enemies and activity on screen. The gameplay loop of Choplifter is the same regardless of which version you play. You pilot a helicopter that flies deep into enemy territory in an attempt to extract hostages. When you break open different structures, you'll see people escaping it, land next to them, and they'll try to board your chopper. Once you have 16 hostages, you can't carry anymore and have to go back to base to successfully extract them. Once you've extracted 40 hostages, you've completed the level. Of course, things are never that easy. You operate on a standard life system, but there is also a secondary objective. If too many hostages die, you automatically game over. There are many ways for the tiny sprite people to die, some of them even by your hand. While enemies can shoot them, your projectiles will also hurt them, and landing on them will instantly kill them. The landing deaths are made a bit less annoying by the AI, who will do their best to spread out and make room for you if they anticipate your descent. The main way you're likely to lose hostages, though, is when you're attempting to extract them. If you get shot down while carrying people on your chopper, they will all die and count towards your casualty limit. This gives Choplifter a pacing unique for the era. Your initial search for hostages to rescue is low risk, and avoiding enemies and hazards isn't too difficult. Once you begin collecting hostages, repositioning yourself, fending off ground units, and in general trying to not get killed, the stakes become higher. Then, the return to base carries the highest risk, keeping things tense until you reach the sanctity of your base. Doing this all within a few minutes and repeating it 3 to 4 times per stage makes one quickly realize why Sega saw potential in the game as an arcade title. The game has 6 missions, which will take you through 3 unique areas, one of which is recolored to nighttime for some additional variety. After completing it, you're rewarded with a credit screen, but sadly with not so much as a thank you for playing message. Even though the game can be beaten in 20 minutes, chances are you're gonna need hours of practice to be able to pull that off. It's possible to replenish lives, but there's no continue system in place, and the addition of a secondary game over condition does make things as challenging as you'd expect from an arcade port. While I'm personally not a fan of Choplifter, there's just something about how it plays that I don't like. It is a well-made title, and there's good reason it was so prevalent across gaming platforms of the 80s. And this is also a good opportunity for me to highlight how the Master System version is superior in every way to the NES version. Considering how much of a luxury that is, I'm willing to give Choplifter extra points just for that. Thank you for watching the latest episode of Eurobits. What was your favorite version of Choplifter? Let me know in the comments below, and if you enjoyed the show, make sure to like, subscribe, and share it with your friends. You can also follow me on Twitch for less scripted commentary. I'd like to thank SegaRetro.org, SMSPower.org, and the Sega Master System Compendium by Bitmapbooks for further informing the recording of this video. A big thank you to World of Longplace as well for the additional non-Master System footage. You can find links to them in the description below.